Hello students, how are you all? Hope you all are doing well at your home. Okay children, so I had given you the solution of the worksheet which I had given you related to Indian and international number system. Okay, so today we will be starting with estimating numbers, or we can say rounding of numbers. And I'll give you one worksheet related to estimation also. And on Monday, I'll give you the solution of the given worksheet. Fine. So let us start with estimating numbers. Estimation is also called as rounding off. Rounding off numbers. Suppose there are 39 students in a class, and if I ask you that tell me approximately how many students were there in that class, then what will you say? You will say there were around how many students? 40 students. There were around 40 students in that particular class. So this 40 is the estimation of this 39. It means finding if here it is 39, then we will find the number which is closer to this 39. We have to find out the multiple of 10 which is closer to this 39. So the multiple of 10 which is closer to this 39 is 40. It is in the case when we have to round off to nearest tens. Okay, so that is why we have rounded off this to 40, because 39 is closer to 40. Now we can round off the numbers to nearest tens, hundreds and thousands. Okay, so now we will be starting with one by one. Firstly we will start with nearest tens, then hundreds, and then we will come to the nearest thousands. Okay, so now I'm going to tell you how to round off the numbers to nearest tens. Okay children, so first of all we have to see that on which place we have to round off. We have to round off to nearest tens. So you have to firstly see that which digit is there on tens place. Which digit is there on tens place? On tens place there is 5. So I have underlined this 5. Okay, firstly we have to underline the digit which is on tens place, and the next step is we have to highlight the digit which is on its right. These two steps are clear. Now we should know that 57 lies in between 50 and 60. Fine. Now we have to compare this highlighted digit with 5. We have to compare this highlighted digit with 5. If the highlighted digit is greater than 5, if it is greater than 5, then it will be rounded up. Rounded up means it will be rounded off to the next tens. So 57 will be rounded off to 60, because 7 is greater than 5. And if it is less than 5, then it will be rounded off to this 50. It means previous tens. Fine. Let's come to B part. Again, firstly we have to see which digit is there on tens place. On tens place there is 9. Now we have to highlight the digit which is on its right. Now the next step is we should know that where it lies. It lies in between 490 and 500. Fine. Now we have to compare this 3 with 5. This 3 is less than 5. If it is less than 5, then it will be rounded off to previous tens. Previous tens means this will be equal to 490. And if it is greater than 5, then that will be rounded off to the next tens. Next tens means this 500. Clear? So that is how we have to round off the numbers to nearest tens. Now let's come to rounding off to nearest hundreds. Next is rounding off to nearest hundreds. So children, here we have to round off to nearest hundreds. So we should know that which digit is there on which place? Hundreds place, because we are rounding off to hundreds. So which digit is there on hundreds place? There is 3 on hundreds place. Now what is the next step? We have to highlight the digit which is on its right. Okay, now we should know that where it lies. It lies in between 300 and 400, because we are rounding to nearest hundreds. Then we have to take the gap of hundreds, 300 and 400. Now we have to compare this 4 with 5. This 4 is less than 5. If it is less than 5, then it will be rounded off to previous tens, previous hundreds, sorry, because we are rounding to nearest hundreds. So it will be rounded off to previous hundreds. Previous hundred means 300. Fine. Now let's come to the next part. Again, we will see which digit is there on hundreds place. On hundreds place, there is 3. Now we will highlight the digit which is on its right. Now we must know where it lies. It lies in between 5300 and 5400. Then we have to compare this 7 with 5. This 7 is greater than 5, then it will be rounded off to the next hundreds. Next hundred means 5400. Is it clear? So that is how we have to do rounding off the numbers to nearest hundreds. Now we will come to nearest thousands. Now the next one is rounding off to nearest thousands. Now we have to round off the numbers to thousands. Okay, so what should we know? We should know that which digit is there on thousands place, because we are rounding off to nearest thousands. So which digit is there on thousands place? On thousands there is 2. Now the next step is we have to highlight the digit which is on its right. Okay, now we have to see that where does it lie. It lies in between 2000 and 3000. Fine. So now we should compare this 1 with 5. This 1 is less than 5, so it will be rounded off to the previous thousands. Previous thousands means 2000. Okay, so that is how we have to do this A part. Now the next part is B part. In B part, what we have to do? Again, we have to check that which digit is there on thousands place. So which digit is there? On thousands place there is 6. And then we have to highlight the digit which is on its right. And the next step is we have to check that where does this number lie. This number lies in between 6000 and 7000. Fine. Now we have to compare this 2 with 5. So this 2 is less than 5. If it is less than 5, it will be rounded off to previous thousands. Previous thousands means 6000. Clear? Okay. So children, this was about rounding off the numbers to nearest tens, hundreds and then thousands. Now we will start with estimating sum, estimating difference and estimating product. So let us start with estimating sum first. Now we are going to start with estimate the sum. Here we have given estimate the sum by rounding off to nearest tens. It means firstly we have to round up these two numbers to nearest tens. Then we have to add the rounded off numbers. Fine, so let us start with 131 first. So we have to round off to nearest tens. So what is the procedure to round off? Firstly, we have to highlight the digit which is on tens place. Then we have to underline the digit, sorry. And then we have to highlight the digit which is on its right. Then we have to see that where does this number lie? This number lies in between 130 and 140. Now we have to compare this one with 5. This one is less than 5. So this will be rounded off to 130. It means it will be rounded off to the previous tens. This was about 131. And if we talk about 462, then which digit is there on tens place? On tens place there is 6. Now we have to highlight the digit which is on its right. So on right hand side there is 2. Now what we have to do? We have to check that where does this number lie? This number lies in between 460 and 470. Now we have to compare this 2 with 5. This 2 is less than 5. If it is less than 5, it will be rounded off to the previous tens. Previous tens means 460. Now we have to add this 130 and 460. So 131 is equal to 130 and 462 is equal to 460. So 0 plus 0 is 0, 6 plus 3 is 9, 4 plus 1 is 5. So 590 is the estimated sum of these two numbers. Fine, that is how we have to estimate the sum. Now we will move to estimate the difference. Next one is estimate the difference by rounding off to nearest hundreds. Now firstly, what we have to do? We have to round off these two numbers to nearest hundreds. And then we have to find out the difference of the estimated numbers. So firstly, we are going to round off this 783 to nearest hundreds. So what we have to do, we have to check which digit is there on hundreds place. So on hundreds place there is 7. Now we have to highlight the digit on its right. Next step is we should know where does it lie. It lies in between 700 and 800. Now we have to compare this 8 with 5. This 8 is greater than 5, so it will be rounded off to the next hundreds. Next hundreds means 800. Fine. Now we have to round off this 393. This 393, which digit is there on hundreds place? On hundreds place there is 3. And which digit is there on its right? On right of this 3 there is 9. Now we should know where does it lie. It lies in between 300 and 400. Now we have to compare this 9 with 5. So this 9 is greater than 5. If it is greater than 5, then it will be rounded off to the next hundreds. Next 100 means 400. Is it clear? Now we have to find out the difference between this 800 and 400. This 783 is equal to 800 and 393 is equal to 400. 800 minus 400 is 400. So this is the method to estimate the difference by rounding off to nearest hundreds. See children, here I have given to nearest hundreds. It can be nearest tens also, and there can be nearest thousands also. Okay, so according to the given question, you have to solve the question. If it is given nearest thousands, then you will round up the numbers to nearest thousands, and then you will find the difference. And if it is given round of by rounding off to nearest tens, then firstly you will round up the numbers to nearest tens, and then you will find the difference. Okay, now let's move to estimate the product. Next is estimate the product by rounding off to nearest thousands. So what we have to do children, we have to round off these two numbers to nearest thousands, and then we have to find out the product. Product means then we have to multiply the estimated numbers. Okay, so let us start with 1410. Now we have to round off to nearest thousands. So we should know which digit is there on thousands place. So in thousands place there is 1. Now we have to highlight the digit which is on its right. So on right there is 4. Now we should know where does it lie. It lies in between 1000 and 2000. Now we have to compare this 4 with 5. This 4 is less than 5, so it will be rounded off to the previous thousands. Previous thousands means 1000, and next thousand means 2000. Okay, next is 7307. Fine, now which digit is there on thousands place? On thousands place there is 7. And which digit is there on its right? On right hand side there is 3. Now we have to compare this 3 with 5. So this 3 is less than 5. But firstly, one step is missed out. What was the step? We should know that where does it lie? It lies in between 7000 and 8000. Now this 3 is less than 5. So it will be rounded off to the previous thousand. Previous thousand means 7000. Now we have rounded off the numbers. Now we should multiply these estimated numbers. So 1410 is equal to 1000, and 7307 is equal to 7000. Now it is easy to multiply these numbers. 1 multiply 7 is 7. Now we can put the zeros. 3 plus 3, it means 6 zeros we have to put. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is our estimated product. Clear? So that is how we have to find out the estimated product. Okay children, so this was about estimation, and this was about estimating sum, difference and product. Okay, so I will give you one worksheet related to estimation today. Okay, only these kind of questions were there, don't worry. You just have to practice those questions in your practice notebook. Okay, and on Monday I'll be giving you the solutions. You have to cross check your answers. And if by mistake any questions you have done wrong, then you can make it correct with the help of the given solutions. Fine, so that's all for today children. Thank you so much. God bless you all.